the heat transfer, and in the last lecture we were talking about the conduction heat transfer. We have talked about the conduction, and we have talked about the convection, and we have said that the convection is a special type of the conduction, but in this case, in the convection case, it is not a pure heat transfer. Okay, this is not a pure, because in this heat transfer you have the fluid moving, fluid flow, as well as the conduction itself. Okay, so conduction and the fluid flow happens at the same time, and we call this fluid flow as the advection. Okay. This one was the topic of the previous lecture, and also we have used the conduction equation, which is equal to negative Ka and dt by dx. We have said that the negative sign is used. This is just a convention. Okay, this one is a convention here. So we are using that you should have the positive heat transfer in the x direction, or it is to ensure that the heat transfer happens from the higher temperature to the lower temperature. But you should remember that there is a negative sign always in this conduction equation. Now I'm going to talk about the radiation or the thermal radiation heat transfer, and this thermal radiation heat transfer, it starts from the as a concept of the electromagnetic waves. Okay. But this electromagnetic wave is, you know, that due to temperature difference. So due to temperature difference, you will have the thermal radiation. And the famous example is that you have the sun and you have the earth. Okay. This one is a typical example of the thermal radiation. And from the sun to the earth, the heat comes as a radiation. Or it can be another example is that the oven in your house, so that the or the oven, yeah, it may be a different types of it, just to make it clear, you can have the bonfire under you. This one is also the thermal radiation, and we have said that air has a very low conductivity, and since it has a very low conductivity, and then the heat transfer from the source in a, you know, that if the medium is air to you, mostly is the radiation. Okay. And here the thermal radiation, it doesn't require any medium. This is the, that is for, that it doesn't need any medium. I mean here that it can transfer in vacuum too. It's very possible because that the sun energy comes to earth passing through the vacuum. It doesn't need any, so any, you know, that the medium to travel through it. Okay, so that it means that when you go from one place, say that from A, when you go to another place with B, and when you move from A to B, you need, for example, some types of transport, for example, bus or taxi or your own car, etc. But for the electromagnetic wave or the thermal radiation, when it travels from A to B, it doesn't need any means. It doesn't need, it can travel without any means here. And the thermal radiation can be in the volumetric type, and also it can be a surface phenomenon. The volumetric type means that it happens over all the volume. But the surface phenomena happens, famous example is the opaque bodies. Okay, opaque body means that it is not transparent. That when the body is not a transparent body, so the transparent is that you cannot see through it. When you look at it, you only see the surface. For the opaque bodies, the thermal radiation is a surface phenomenon. What is the surface phenomenon? Let me give you the example here. Say that I have a body here for the thermal radiation. So that for that body, I will have the, so that, so the incident radiation. And some of this incident radiation will be reflected. Okay. And so that incident radiation, say that this one is 100%. Okay. And reflected part is, I don't know, that approach, say that this one is that 20% is reflected. And then you will have that some of it will be, you know, that passing through the body here. Okay. And this one will be transmitted. Okay. and transmitted portion, let's say that this one is at 30%, okay, and then you will have the absorbed portion here. So that this one is absorbed. And the absorbed portion will be that 50%. So you can see that overall it makes 100%. Okay. And here you have the source temperature. Here you have the surface temperature. With surface and the source temperature, you have the electromagnetic radiation. Okay. And the next is that this surface, okay, since it is hot, and it will also, you know, that emit radiation. So this body that emit radiation. And this emission of the radiation is due to TS, or internal energy of the body. Okay, for if I give you the reflection, say that the reflection you have, and you have the emission. Okay, reflection, this one doesn't decrease. That is T body. But emission, this one decreases the T body. So emission decreases the body temperature, or the TS, or TS here. But the reflection doesn't decrease the surface temperature. Okay? It only, you know, that it is reflected back. So there is no relation with the internal energy of the body. Okay, that is how the thermal, that is that thermal radiation happens. And for the reflection here, we are using the rho. It means that the reflectivity, and for the transmission here, you are using the transmissivity, which is the tau here, and for the absorption, you are using the absorptivity, which is alpha. Okay, and the emission, we are using the emissivity, which is epsilon, and the alpha and plus tau and the plus rho, it makes one. Okay, and the Kirchhoff's law says that the alpha is equal to epsilon. Okay, and that this one is at T given and lambda given. For given lambda and the temperature, the alpha is same as the epsilon. But you should remember, as I said in our previous parts of the lecture, is that the thermal radiation here, this one, that incident radiation, it is a function of that the lambda, it is function of the temperature, it is function of the angle direction. Okay, you can feel it for the direction concept is that put your hands, so that if you put your hands over fire versus if you put hands at some angle with respect to fire. Okay, you can see that if you put your hands over the fire, you will feel more heat versus if you put some under angle to the fire. Okay? You will feel less heat. Therefore, the incident radiation, or the as well as this emissive radiation, the absorptivity, transmissivity, and this one all, the alpha, that rho, and therefore tau, and the emission, these are all functions of the lambda, temperature, and the angle. Angle I mean here is that you will have that. Let me just write the angle here. You will have the angle here. Your direction. Say that you have an opaque body here. This one is opaque. Okay. And do you have the thermal radiation falling on it? So this one is the thermal radiation here, falls on that body here. That is thermal radiation. Okay. When it falls on that body, since the body is opaque, so that thermal radiation is, you know, that absorbed, so that along these lengths here. Okay. Absorbed at the surface. So the rest of the body doesn't, you know, that interact with this radiation simultaneously. Okay, only the surface here for the opaque bodies. Opaque means that it is not transparent. They're not transparent. And for the transparent bodies, the concept is a bit different. For the transparent bodies, the thermal radiation travels through the body. And just 1 minute. For the transparent bodies, if I have the thermal radiation falling on the body, so that I have the thermal radiation here, falls on the body. This thermal radiation passes through the body, and it transmits. Okay. So it is also possible that if you have, for example, interacting medium, some may be absorbed. So it's possible that some may be absorbed or some may be reflected. But for transparent bodies, it is transmitted and the some is absorbed here. Okay, and then some may be reflected, and this is the total radiation. Very similar to the light concept. When the light falls on the body, since this has the same nature as the light, both are the electromagnetic wave. So that when the light falls on the body, some is reflected, some is absorbed, and some is transmitted. And this is actually for the semi-transparent body. For the opaque bodies, but it is not. It is only absorbed at the surface. And the famous example is that in foggy weather, when you move with your car, so that car light in foggy weather. So when you move in foggy weather in your car with your car light. And you can see that the car light only, you know, that penetrates a small depth of the fog, and you cannot see the rest because the fog is an opaque body, and the light is absorbed at a small part of the surface. Okay, very small part of the surface. Okay, and we have the Stefan Boltzmann law, and the Stefan Boltzmann law says that the Q dot the radiation is equal to that sigma and temperature to the power of 4. Okay. And this one is the surface temperature. For the real surfaces, the radiation from the body is not equal to, this one is for ideal surface. In ideal case, that the radiation from the body is sigma temperature surface to the power of the 4. And the sigma is that Boltzmann constant. Okay. It should be 6.67 10 to the negative 8. And if you look at the units here, it will be that watts per and Kelvin to the power of 4. And here you have also the surface, A surface. Surface A and the meter square. This is the Stefan Boltzmann law. But for the real surfaces, the Stefan Boltzmann law will be modified with a coefficient here, so that Q dot radiation for the real surfaces, it will be that epsilon here and the sigma T surface to the power of 4 and the area surface. And this epsilon, it is called emissivity. So that emissivity of the body. This epsilon is less equal to 1 and greater than 0. And the emissivity is 1 for the ideal body. The body is ideal, so the emissivity is 1. Okay. And one more thing here is that the combined heat transfer coefficient, now let's see it. For the combined heat transfer coefficient, so for combined heat transfer coefficient. So say that this is the window of the room. Okay, this one is the window cross section. That for that window of the house. So the window of the house, from the inside of the room, so if it is the inside, it will be by the conduction. But from outside of it, you will have the heat loss by convection, that heat loss by convection, and you will have heat loss by radiation. You will lose the heat from outside of the house. It can be window, it can be the wall, it doesn't matter, but for the case, let's talk about the window here. For this window, you will lose the heat of the house by convection and by radiation. So if the surface temperature is TS here, say that this one is TS, and the environment is at the temperature of the T infinity. This one is at TS, and this one is at T infinity. Now we are trying to find what is the convection heat loss and the radiation heat loss. The convection heat loss, Q dot Cv, it will be equal to that H and the AS, TS minus T infinity for the convection heat transfer. But for the radiation heat transfer, Q dot radiation, it will be that you will have the epsilon, you will have the sigma, you will have the AS. You can see that they are the similar till now, and the TS to the power of 4, and the T infinity to the power of 4. Okay. And the one thing that I forgot to tell you is that this TS always in Kelvin. It should be always in Kelvin. This is the equation for the radiation. And for this radiation equation, now what I will do is that we should combine these two equations here. We should combine it. And we should add it. Okay, so that Q dot total will be equal to Q dot Cv plus Q dot radiation. Now what I will do for the radiation part is that I will just write it again here. So it will be that epsilon sigma As. Instead of this one, I will just write Ts to the power of 2. Plus T infinity to the power of 2 and multiplied with Ts to the power of 2 minus T infinity to the power of 2. Okay, so I will, you know that, write this one more time here. Epsilon sigma As and Ts squared T infinity squared. And instead of that one, I will, you know that, express it as Ts minus T infinity and Ts plus T infinity. Now you can see that my equations for both of it, Ts minus T infinity and Ts minus T infinity, and you have this AS here, and the rest will be the radiation coefficient. So let me just write this one epsilon, and then you will have that sigma, and then you will have this TS plus T infinity squared, and TS plus the T infinity here. So this one, and that one, and that one. It will be that H of radiation. So radiation transfer coefficient. Radiation heat transfer coefficient. You can see that I've just modified the equation. And therefore, the total heat transfer, if I write it, it will be that HAS, this one is CV now, and TS minus T infinity, and plus H radiation here, AS, TS minus T infinity. As you can see that the radiation and the convection heat transfer coefficient has, you know that it has got the similarity. Okay? They have the similar equation for the convection and similar equation for the radiation. I can go one more step here that AS, TS minus T infinity, and this one will be added. So that HCV plus H radiation. Okay, and this is called the H combined. So that in most of the equations that combined heat transfer coefficient is given. So if you have a problem, in that problem, combined heat transfer coefficient is given. And this combined means that they are also considering the convection and they are also considering the radiation. Okay, it's both are given. And when we neglect the radiation heat transfer, we neglect the radiation heat transfer when you have the forced convection. When you have forced convection, the radiation heat transfer will be very small, and therefore we neglect it. But for the natural convection, free convection, the radiation part is also important. And the last part is that the Kirchhoff's law, and the Kirchhoff's law says that at given lambda, lambda is the wavelength, and the temperature, at given lambda and the temperature, the epsilon of the body, which is given us here, so they can see that it is emissivity, will be equal to, that is the alpha. That emission, this one is the emission, emissivity, let me just write it as emissivity. This one is the absorptivity. The absorptivity is emissivity. It is that the that energy that it releases. This is emissivity. Absorptivity, the name says it. That is the energy that it absorbs. When it, I've shown it to you, when you have the total radiation, some is absorbed, some is reflected, and some is transmitted. Okay, and you have also the emission. Emission. And you can see that now you have the emission and the reflection. So the emission and the reflection is a different concept. Okay, reflection is the that related to at that time. So that when the wave falls, some is reflected, some is absorbed, and some is transmitted. These are happening at the same time. But the emission is the internal energy of the body. The emission is related to internal energy of the body. When the emission happens, the body internal energy drops. Okay. There may be that body doesn't reflect, but it always emits. It's possible. Okay, because if the body is hot, so that emission happens, let me just write it here. When that T surface is greater than 0 Kelvin. When the temperature of the surface is greater than 0 Kelvin, you will always have the emission. Okay, you cannot stop the emission, but you can stop the reflection. You can make the surface such that at given wavelength and the temperature, at the given temperature and the wavelengths, the body doesn't reflect. It always absorbs. Okay. But and you can see the emissivity of the some surfaces at 20 degrees Celsius. But the temperature for the thermal radiation is very important. Okay, that because the thermal radiation, these are the function of the wavelengths and the function of the temperature and the function of the direction. Okay. So that angle, call it as the angle. So that because the wavelengths, the temperature and the angular behavior change the radiation. It is very important stuff. And for the emissivity at 25 degrees Celsius, for aluminium foil, you can see it is 0.04. It doesn't emit at 25 degrees Celsius. Asphalt is, it is very high. So that therefore in that 25 degrees Celsius, you can feel the coldness of the asphalt because the emissivity is very high. The brick and the red rough brick is 0.93. You can see these are very high and very close to ideal body. Cotton cloth is 0.77 and the soil is 0.9. The human body is 0.95 and the water is 0.95. All of them are approximately that the black body or the ideal body. It's also called that black body. Black body doesn't mean that it is black. Black body means that that since the black surfaces absorb the light, black body means that that with the similarity, it absorbs all of the radiation. Whatever radiation you have it absorbs all. So that for the black bodies, you have the absorptivity is 1, reflection is 0, and then you have this transmission is 0. Transmission is 0. It absorbs all, and the emissivity is same as the absorptivity for the black bodies. Okay, we will have a separate chapter for the thermal radiation. These are just introduction. And if I have a surface, something like this one, and there is an environment, let's say that this one is at 20 degrees Celsius, and this one will be at TS, and you will have that thermal radiation on that body. And you will have that thermal radiation. This one is that incident. We call it as incident radiation. And the sum of this incident radiation will be emitted. So you will have this emission here. Okay. And therefore, this TS and the 20 degrees Celsius, this is the important part that we are interested in. As I said, some will be absorbed, some will be reflected, some will be transmitted. Okay. These are not important for now. They are important in how much is emitted. This one is important stuff. Okay. And for the opaque bodies, as I said, the radiation is opaque solid. Radiation is 0. And the opaque solid, if I ask this question, what is the, the convection? What is the amount of the convection for this solid body? So can you just write your answer as a comment? So for the opaque solid, so for the solid, this one is solid. It doesn't move. If it doesn't move, the convection is zero. Okay, so that you will only have the conduction. For the gases, so you will have the radiation is not equal to zero. And the convection, you may have the convection, it is possible. And you may have the conduction. But the convection and the conduction, not at the same time. Okay, not at the same time. So you will either have the convection, you will either have the conduction. So if it is in case of the convection, let's see when it is the convection and the radiation. And for the convection and the radiation, so say that this one is the Q dot CV convection, and this one is that Q dot radiation. If it is convection, the gas moves. Okay. But in the gas inside the system here, it will move. So how it moves, it may be in a loop, for example, like this one. The gas moves. But if it is that you will have the conduction, so if it is conduction, then the gas here, you know that doesn't move, it is stationary, and then you will have the radiation and the conduction at the same time. For this case, the gas doesn't move. It is stationary. For the last case is the vacuum case, and for the vacuum case, you will only have only Q dot radiation. Only Q dot radiation. You don't have the conduction here, which is zero. You don't have the convection here, which is zero. Okay. Now there is an example here. We have a person standing in at 25 degrees Celsius. Determine the rate of heat transfer from the person if she, he has average outer temperature of 30 degrees Celsius. Take convection coefficient as 10 watt per meter squared degrees Celsius. You can find the surface area of a person using the correlation given by the Du Bois in 1916 as 0.202 m to the power of 0.425 and h to the power of 0.725. M is mass here and h is height. By using the values here, we will find what is the heat transfer from the body. Say that this one is the person here. And for this person here, so that you will have the convection heat transfer from the body, you will have the Q dot radiation. And you will also have that, you know, that the Q dot CV, convection. The question is, what is the conduction and the convection heat transfer from this person? Okay, so that the environment is at, so this is the environment. It is at 25 degrees Celsius, and the body temperature is at 30 degrees Celsius. The person has a body temperature of 30 degrees Celsius. Question is the heat transfer coefficient. Now let's first start with the convection part. The convection will be that H, and the surface area, HCV, surface area, and the TS minus T infinity. Okay. And the TS is, that is 30 degrees Celsius, T infinity is 25 degrees Celsius, and the convection heat transfer coefficient is that given as that 10 here, and the surface area of the person, AS of person. And for this one, we'll use the equation given by the Du Bois and the 1916, equation is as 0.202 mass to the power of 0.425 and the height to the power of 0.725. Okay. And by using this equation, we will find the surface area of the person. And then from that surface area, we will find the convection heat transfer coefficient. Okay, so, and the mass and the height, let's just write it. The mass of the person, let's say that it is about 80 kilograms, and the height is 1.8 meters. Okay, this is the mass of the person. You will just replace it here, and this is the height of the person, and you will just calculate it. We have to calculate the Q dot radiation. A similar concept again. So you will have the epsilon, and you will have the AS, you will have the sigma, and the TS minus T infinity. Both are for the power of 4. Now let's just calculate it. And so that for the Boltzmann coefficient, let me. So the Boltzmann coefficient is, I think I have written this one is here 6 point. This one is 5 point. Okay, 5.67. Now let me just write it. So that epsilon for the human body. So if you go back to here, the epsilon for the human skin is 0.95. So that for the human body, epsilon will be that 0.95. The surface area of the body will be this Du Bois correlation here, and it makes us 1.992 here. And the sigma value is 5.67 times 10 to the power of negative 8. And the surface temperature, so you should work with this one always in Kelvin. If you work with this Kelvin units, and the 30 degrees Celsius will be have that 273 plus 30 here. And for the T infinity, which is at 25 degrees Celsius, 273 plus 25 degrees Celsius. And this will be the equation that you are going to have. So the final form of that equation will be that epsilon 0.95 times 1.992 and times 5.67, 10 to the power of negative 8. And TS is that, this makes that 303 to the power of 4 minus 298 to the power of. So that at the end you will, you know, that combine it so that the person loses heat by convection, the person loses it by the conduct radiation, and then you combine it, you will have the total heat transfer loss from the person. 8 watts by the radiation, and you have that 99 watts per that is convection. If I combine it, so that Q-dot total will be equal to that. If you sum this two, and you will get 148. 0.78 watts. Okay. It is 150 watts approximately heat loss from the body. So it is equal to, so that you can, you know, that power up to 7 lamps. Okay, 7 lamps of 20 watts. So that with the heat loss from the heat loss here, that is energy loss. With this energy loss, if you utilize it, you can power 7 lamps. Okay, so that now comes the last part of our first lecture. The last part is that we will look at the two cases here. First will be the microwave oven and the first versus the convection oven here. So we have two ovens. First one is the microwave oven and the other one is the convection oven. We'll compare how it works and we'll see how the heat transfer happens from these two ovens. Okay, first with the microwave oven. If you look at it, the components of it is given here. You have the stirrer, you have the waveguide, magnetron, and the power, and the cooking cavity. So you have the cooking cavity where you cook it, and the turntable, and the door, and the choke. Okay, so the main important part here is that you have the magnetron. Okay, and this one generates EM waves, electromagnetic waves. The electromagnetic waves that is being generated by this magnetron is, you know, that falling on this body here, so that we have electromagnetic wave here, that you have electromagnetic wave, you have electromagnetic wave, and electromagnetic wave, electromagnetic wave. This electromagnetic wave generation, these are radiation. Okay, but you should remember that this one is not a thermal radiation. Okay, this one is not thermal radiation. Why it is not the thermal radiation? If you remember, if I go back to here, that the thermal radiation, this one, happens due to temperature difference, okay? But for the microwave oven, the thermal radiation is not due to temperature difference, but it is due to magnetron here. You know that you are generating the electromagnetic wave. Okay? You are generating it and sending over the body, okay? And the body absorbs this thermal radiation. Let me just write the process here, so that we have the radiation. Okay, this radiation falls on the body. Okay, we call it as incident. Okay, incident, and then it is conducted through the inner parts of the body. Okay, this thermal radiation. Sorry, that this radiation falls on the body. And that thermal radiation is transmitted, okay, that is transmitted or conducted to the inner parts of the body. Okay. And you have the conduction heat transfer, and after some time, okay, that the body gets hot. Okay. When the body gets hot, what you will have is that, so that this one will be hot, and it's getting hot, and then you will have the heat removal. Okay, so the body will start to lose heat. This one will be that heat from the body. Okay, after some time. And the body also will know that to lose heat to the environment. Okay. And this heat will be that natural conduction. It is not the radiation, it is a natural conduction. So you have the two heat transfer processes happen at the same time. So you have the conduction that is transferred from the skin of the body to its inner parts, and after some time the body gets a uniform hot temperature. That after that uniform hot temperature, the body transmits its energy to the environment by natural conduction. Okay, this is how microwave oven works. And now comes the convection ovens, these ones. These convection ovens, it can be by free convection, one, and it can be by the forced convection. This one is here. So that free convection is that forced is that you have fan. And this is the natural convection here. And as you can see the heater part here, this one is there. This one, the part here, just use a different color. The part that is shown here, you can see, this one is the heater. Okay. The heater here, you know, that heats the air, so that this one heats air. Okay. As I said, it can be by forced convection or the free convection, but at the end it is by convection. After some time, the air inside this, you know, that convection oven gets very hot. So that it will be, for example, at 200 degrees Celsius. After some time, the air inside is maybe at 200 degrees Celsius. When it gets at that temperature, desired temperature, so that after set temperature, so if the set temperature, what you do is that you put the body inside. It can be, for example, the hen, or it can be some other meat that you are preparing. Okay. And when you put the body inside, you will have the similar process as here. You will have the conduction, and then you will have the conduction. Okay, so similar processes will happen as here, but you can see the similarities and the differences. The first similarity is that, so that difference is that here you are using the electromagnetic waves, but here you are using the convection of the oven. And this convection, you know, that can be, so you can see the impeller here. This impeller is fan. We have the fan here, and this fan, and as well as you have the filter, etc., heating element, you can see the heating element here. Okay, this is how the convection ovens work. And this one is faster because you are not heating the air here. You are just heating the object here, the hen or the meal here. But for the convection ovens, this one is slower because here you are heating the air. First, you are heating air, and then you are heating the meal that you are putting inside the oven. Okay. So with this one, I have finished the thermal radiation and the introduction, the heat transfer part. And next lecture, we will talk about the conduction equation.